Hello everyone, so I'm back. So this time I'm coming to you guys with sharing some knowledge on intent-based networking, which is one of the leading buzzword in industry, and that too for a network administrator. In order to understand what is intent-based networking, this video should help you out from the basics, and we will kickstart with this intent-based networking with how and why and with introduction to Cisco SDA in this video. And more videos are in pipeline to showcase and deep dive on Cisco SDA with the service component, definition, demos, and integration, all those things. Okay, so don't waste time. Let's not waste time, I would say like that. Let's kick off. So the agenda of the presentation today would be, what is intent-based networking? We heard a lot about intent-based networking, but let me try to explain with my articulation what you mean by actually intent-based networking and how intent-based networking works. So if you understand what, then you need to know how and why you want an intent-based networking. So that three pointers will help you out to understand and frame you guys to know what is intent-based networking. Then we will see what are the challenges with the traditional network today in campus or more of the complex networks, and how software-defined access, which is Cisco's latest introduction or invention or innovation in networking technology. So we'll have some understanding of SDA as an overcome issue of the challenges, and the next consecutive slides will be speaking everything on Cisco SDA with start from their component, integration, demos, and all those things. Okay, so let me start. What is intent-based networking? Intent by definition means an objective or a goal, which could be of anything, but in our terminology of intent-based networking, it is nothing but a language which actually bridges the gap. It actually bridges the gap between your business language and your networking language, right? So normally, if you understand or if you see most of the standard definition, it's an intent. It's a language which bridges the gap between your business and IT, because both are altogether a different source. One is north and another is south, correct? And what it mainly is, it actually tries to capture the business intent to its more 80 to 90%, and try to align that business language into an end-to-end network with that particular intent, or with that particular goal, or with that particular objective. So what will happen in this case is, you can think that from a network manager point of view, if you want to define a high level business policy, that particular policy will be placed onto a network with an automated orchestrator, and the software will implement that policy. So that would be behind the screen like a charm or like magic. That is called as an intent-based networking, along with predictions and assurance and threat detection proactive. So everything combined. So we are going to see how and what are all the key pillars which actually makes it as an intent-based networking, right? So what we are saying is here is, let's see, this is one of our network administrator, which is an IT, and this is the business language. So intent-based networking actually bridges the gap. So how, that is we are going to see in our next slide. So on a high level, so this is intent-based networking. To wrap up this particular slide, so fundamentally, intent-based networking is nothing but, it's an idea. It's an idea of a network administrator or a network engineer, which define a desired state of network, which is automated network orchestrator, and software implement those policies. So what that actually gives a benefit, it actually abstracts the network complexity. You don't need to go and configure some complex command in all the devices and trying to understand the business logic, also another problem. So on aligning with that particular logic and doing the configuration on each and every devices, it's a cumbersome task. Also, it gives you a benefit of automation. So you just define a high level policies of your business logic. Rest of the thing of making that particular policy into an end-to-end desired network state, it's automatically done by an intelligent-based network with some machine learning languages and algorithms which have been running behind the screen, and automatically it orchestrated across your network like a piece of cake. So that is called an intent-based networking on a very high level, right? So with next slide, what we say, how the intent-based networking is going to work. So this is one of the key slide which actually capture some of the pillars of intent-based networking. So in our previous slide, we understand on a high level what is intent-based networking. This slide speaks out on a bit deeper level what are all the key pillars which on what basis intent-based networking works. Okay. So what we say as intent-based networking system, if you say an intent-based networking, so it's a compress of a network system which normally monitor continuously and identify and react on real time for any changes happening in your networking domain to make your system always live and healthy, right? So it actually, what happens in today's world, what happens in today's network, the translation is done manually. Algorithm validation are absent. So what do you mean by that actually? So four major characteristics. So that is what I've been saying is the pillars. So this is the first pillar, what we say, translation and validation. So the key belief of intent-based networking system is its ability to translate the command from network into a software area. I mean, the idea is, or you can say in the software implementation, you can say the command from network admin into a software system. Here the idea is network manager, you can say, the network manager is defining some high level business policy which they want to enforce in network, that particular translation happens. So that is what we say, translation, and that particular policy is converted and validated to force into network. So that is what I'm showing here is. So what is the key belief of IBNS is to an ability to translate the command from network into action. That is the number one characteristics. And the number two, automated implementation. Here we are not going to ask any network engineer to do this type of command in CLI and go and switch one or switch two or switch three. Nothing is going to happen. Everything is an overlay and everything works on each and every domain. So every network is interconnected and it actually gives or help you out to achieve your business intent into a network step. So what we say in automated implementation, once the policy is defined by your network manager, I'm just taking the previous example of the network manager. So intent-based networking system software, it actually manipulates the network resources. So it manipulates the network underlay resource to create the desired state and enforce the policy. So that is why we are saying automated implementation. So it will know that where exactly the endpoints and where exactly the policy or the configuration need to be applied as per the requirement or the business logic, and it will automatically implement that. That is what we are saying in characteristic number two, correct? And third one is your awareness of state. It gathers the data. The data gathering in intent-based networking system is one of the key factors, which it continuously monitor the state of the network, right? So that it is aware what is happening in your network and it can react accordingly with an assurance and dynamic reaction. That is what the four characteristics, right? So what we are saying is, in assurance and dynamic reaction is, intent-based networking constantly ensure that your desired state of your network is maintained, which uses some machine learning languages to choose the best, the best way to implement the desired state or to maintain the state, and can take appropriate actions to maintain the state, right? I mean, what we're saying is that assurance and dynamic reaction is more of an what do you say, if you say I am assuring that this particular content is the fact, that you don't need to worry about the concept, right? So that assurance what I'm giving is based on my experience. So that is what happens in intent-based networking. So assurance actually help you to give the state that it is maintained with their intelligent algorithms or machine learning language, and it can take automated corrective action. So you don't need to worry for a reactive mode. It is a more proactive, or even you can say predictive also at times. Okay. So this is more about how intent-based networking works. So if you join all the four pillars, 1+2+3+4 means translation and validation, plus automated implementation, plus awareness of the state, plus assurance and dynamic reaction, that makes the overall thing as an intent-based networking, right? So if in nutshell, if I say intent-based networking system gives a network administrator the ability to define what they want to achieve the network to do, and make it as a more automated network management platform. That is what intent-based networking. How that has been achieved with these four pillars. Make sense? Yeah. So as we know what is intent-based networking and how it is being, working on the ground. So what business benefit intent-based networking, going to give us? That is why we are saying as a why factor. So first we say the speed and agility. Network is able to respond rapidly to any organization need with a zero time frame. That is one of the power in intent-based networking. You can, create a policy or configuration within a span of time. You don't need to worry. And it's a value to business. Value to business, what I'm saying is, why I'm saying it's a value to business, because of its reduced time and effort. You don't need to worry because the time and effort are reduced. So you can work on more of a network, IT innovation time. You can more work on that, network translate into more time for IT innovation. You don't need to worry about the network configuration. A lot of things you can do on top of that. So it is a value to business, right? And the reduced risk. One of the key thing is reduced risk, because you have a complete network visibility, analytics, and automation, which actually makes a faster detection, and you can think about more faster detection and threat prevention. So that is what is called reduced risk, because of it's constantly monitoring the health of the state of the or state of the network or the domain, so it can easily predict what the problem is on a more predictive or faster response. The final one is a higher security. Because of the nature of this, you can design the policy more on a micro segmentation or macro segmentation concept, where it is more with respect to so it's a group based policy for device to device, not on IP based concept. So these are the four major business benefits what intent based networking actually giving to an enterprise world. So with those three slides, the basic definition of what is intent based networking. Now what we're going to see is the challenges in networks. So what is the current challenges in network today? One of the thing is cumbersome segmentation. You have lots of number of users and endpoint types, with a lot of technologies getting evolved, IoT devices, printers, laptops, desktops, where you have increasing number of VLANs and IPs. So it is actually the segmentation, if you want to do in traditional campus network or a network, it's not an easy task, right? You need to have a VLAN spanned, VLAN need to be aligned and all those things. It's one of the pain actually, number one. And the number two is the complexity. As the segmentation or the ask of a security from the enterprise or the business is more secure network you want, segment, do proper segmentation so that you can control the things. So then the problem comes about the management complexity. You need to do management of multiple devices, multiple checkpoints, multiple areas where you need to touch or do the configuration. Could be, branch firewall, branch routers, branch switches, branch wireless controllers, all those things. So a lot of touch points, right? Which makes a complexity bit more complex, which results in a delay. So, and what happens is because of the lot of device involved and the management is distributed or the complexity of configuration is distributed, which results in a slower resolution. So when the delay happens in resolving some critical problem in your network, it's a direct loss to your business during the time you're not able to recover all the resolution or, you know, the problem. So it's everything is interrelated. These are the key challenges which is on the ground today, what overall enterprise or the business is actually facing. So there comes an evolution of software defined access, which is one of the part of digital network architecture of Cisco's DNAC. So we will be speaking more on SDA today. So what SDA is going to help us, how it's actually, you know, overcome the challenges. So SDA comes with the concept of identity based segmentation. It actually, you know, decouples the IP address concept. So it is more of a security policy definition, not like in traditional world of VLAN or IP. They are being used for an identity, not with respect to any specific that this IP address has to be, you know, mapped to some access list. It's more of a policy based concept. So it has decoupled that particular system. The second one is more from point of advanced automation. So as I said, in intent based networking, so SDA actually more of an intent based networking design, which automates the overall configuration, whatever the policy of the business policy you have created across your wired and a wireless infrastructure, so that you have a traffic movement easily going with this desired security policy applied irrespective of the location. And the final one is the telemetry. As I said, because of the, in order to, you know, respond as soon as possible to avoid the resolution delay, you want an advanced telemetry. And the telemetry and analytics inside and business or the end user traffic, it's one of the key aspects of SDA, which help you to resolve more proactive rather reactive concept. Yeah. So with this, I would like to, you know, wrap up this session. So I hope this session was a bit informative to all my viewers. And I just started to give you a definition of intent-based networking system. I hope that was an information for you. And with the start of an SDA as an overcome the challenges what today's traditional world are facing. And keep watching and subscribe the video for more talks. And please do comments for your queries so that I can answer as soon as possible. And I will be adding more now on software defined access, which is Cisco's latest technology front, which will be my subsequent videos in upcoming time. Thank you very much for watching, and I would like to say that have a nice weekend.